With the start of a new month, it is an excellent time to set some goals and feel that motivation to achieve them. So in today's video, I am sharing with you my tips and tricks and how I do that as a mom of three, including a PDF that really helps me to stay on track. So if you like the sound of this video, stay tuned, give it a big thumbs up because it really does support my channel. Don't forget to hit subscribe and tap that bell so you get notified when we upload on Mondays and Thursdays because we're all about parenting with a plan, and today's plan is about setting those goals, feeling that motivation and achieving it. So let's get into it. This is our first time meeting. Thank you so much for clicking on today's video. My name is Beck and I am a mom of three. And sometimes my days feel like they just roll into each other and I don't know what day of the week it is, let alone feel any success. Prior to going on maternity leave, I worked full-time as a learning support teacher and my lifestyle was very different. It was very busy, it was very go, 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 setting goals, achieving goals, and I really do feel accomplished through my line of work. As a mom, there is a different pace of life naturally that is going to come with being a stay-at-home mom. In today's video, I am sharing how I motivate myself to achieve my goals so that I feel like I've done something for myself and that I am improving on myself. I don't want to get caught up with low negative feelings. I really want to make the most of being a stay-at-home mom and enjoy this season of my life. As a visual learner, one thing that really helps me to stay on track is to write things down. I love to just brain dump everything onto paper so I can figure out my thoughts because sometimes I feel like my brain gets so full that I can't even find a way through the forest. To set a goal and to achieve it, I really need to be able to visualize it, figure out if there's anything that's going to stop me from doing it, and that is the reason why I have created today's PDF. You can find it over on our website and download it for free. I have found since implementing this in my routine, both on a weekly and daily scale, it's really helping me to get the most out of each day, to enjoy each day, and to just savor this time that I have at home. When researching what was going to help me in my goal action plan, there were four categories that I think are really vital in achieving and staying motivated towards your goal. Step one is to set it. Have something that is realistic, not too far out of your comfort zone as your first goal. You don't want to be burning yourself out because it's an unrealistic expectation. So set a goal that you think you can achieve with a little bit of discipline. Step two is to write down your motivation behind the goal. For me personally, I'm wanting to tone up my body now that I'm 5 months postpartum. And so my goal is to do exercise 4 days a week, Monday, Tuesday, Thursday, Friday. And my motivation behind it is I want to tone my body up and I want to feel good in my skin. Just because I'm a third time mom doesn't mean that I want a mom bod. I really do want to look after the body that God has given me. I want it to have longevity. I want to be able to see my children grow up and grandchildren. And that is the motivation behind looking after my body right now. The third step is, what is your action plan? Michael also wants to get on this exercise journey with me, and so our action plan is to hold each other accountable, and we are exercising at night when he gets home. I try and have dinner on the table and ready to go so that we finish dinner by 6. That way between 6 and 7 when we're doing the kids' nighttime routine, we're allowing our body to digest our food. So by the time it does come to exercise, we have had about an hour, maybe an hour and a half gap between dinner and us exercising. The fourth step I think is the most important one, which are, what are the roadblocks? Are there anything that is going to prevent you from achieving your goal? Anything that is going to dull your motivation? Write it down and come up with an action plan. Figure out how you're going to conquer it so that you can stay on the path and achieve that goal for the week. So for me personally, I am exhausted at the end of a day and I really don't actually want to exercise. However, I know once I do exercise, I get the endorphins that come from it. So my action plan is the fact that once the kids have had their showers and I'm just about to put dinner on the table, I will get my lower half of my body, so my pants and socks and joggers on, so that I'm ready to exercise. I feel like once I've got my tights on and my runners, I have like a spring in my step and I'm feeling kind of athletic. And so that really helps me to motivate. I can't get my top half dressed because I still have to give Finn his nighttime feed, but I feel like getting the job halfway done really does help me to stay motivated. And Michael and I have really discussed the fact that we need to kind of psych each other up because I think he's just as tired as I am. And so that's how we are conquering that roadblock of exhaustion and really pushing forward. I don't know if it's me, so comment down below, but I love to check things off my list. I love to give myself ticks and just instant gratification that a job was well done. So there is a tracker at the bottom of each goal so that you can color in the bubble, tick the bubble, whatever you would like to do. And there is a spot for you to give yourself a reward, because even though we are adults, it is still really nice to know that there is a carrot at the end of the string. And when it comes to body transformation, like me doing exercising to tone and to just become healthier, I know that I'm not gonna get instant gratification when I look into a mirror. And so I really want to give myself a little treat, a pat on the back to say a job well done. And then at the very bottom of the sheet, there is a monthly tracker with a monthly goal. I'd personally recommend that your weekly goal is just something little, something to give you that boost that you did something good and, you know, to continue to have that motivation that you can achieve your goal. And then at the end of the month, really spoil yourself. So for Michael and I have asked if we could just go on a date night between the two of us and to just enjoy a night out in each other's company and to celebrate a job well done of exercising 4 times a week for a whole month. Finally, in the PDF pack, you will find a sheet called My Week in a Glance. And I feel like since implementing this strategy into my life and getting a broader sequence of how my days are going and how my week is looking overall, I'm feeling less anxious about my week. I am feeling like I'm getting the most out of every opportunity because there are 4 categories that I feel really have helped me. The first category is there anything important that is happening on that day? It could be an appointment, it could be something that the kids need to have. So for me personally, I have to make sure that Amira is at school early on Tuesdays and Thursdays. And she had an incursion this week, so I put that on the calendar. If there were any appointments for Finn or Zoe, that would go on the calendar. If there was something that was happening in Mick's life, that would go in the important section. That way, whatever is a non-negotiable is right up there at the top of the day, so you know what you're going to have to kind of base the rest of the day off. The next step down is mindfulness. Now, this could look different in your household depending on your lifestyle, but for me and my household, my mindfulness activity is, what am I gonna do with my kids? Lately, I have just been feeling the fact that this season is going way too fast. I have seen Amira grow up before my eyes and I know it's just gonna get faster and faster. So every day I really wanna be mindful and do something with the kids. I ask Zoe at the beginning of the day if there's anything she would like to do. Sometimes she says baking, sometimes she says painting, sometimes she says dancing. If she doesn't have an idea of what she really wants to do, then I'll pick something like going for a walk, heading to the park, just playing with her. It doesn't have to be something big. You could even just sit down and have them in your lap and read them a story. But I'm really trying to be mindful of being a mum and being present. You could also include something that is for you in this section. So whether you have a hobby, you have a book that you want to read, or you just want to chill, then that's something you can put in your mindfulness column. The third box down is jobs and cleaning. I feel like once you've gotten the important things out, you've been present in your own life, then get into the jobs and the mundane activities of life, whether that's cleaning up a room, sweeping the floors. If you have a job that you have to do at home to make sure that you're reaching targets, then that's the next step there. And then finally, I have a section of what do I need to get done before bed? How can I set myself up with some preparation for the next day to make it as smoothly as possible? So some things that we are doing at nighttime obviously is exercising, but I'm also hanging out a load of washing. I am food prepping Amira's lunchbox to make sure that that's ready to go in the morning. One less job that I have to do in the chaotic rush of school runs. And then I am able to head off to bed. Having it all laid out in front of me really helps me to see what I can compromise on, what I need to maybe have some more discipline towards achieving and helps me to get motivated to achieve all my goals throughout the week and not get to the end of a day or the end of the week and be like, man, I didn't have time to do that. So I really hope that today's video has helped motivate you, given you some food for thought, and has encouraged you to set some goals for this coming month. Question of the day, what is your goal for this month? I'd love to hear about it, so please comment down below. But as always, if you've liked today's video, please give it a big thumbs up. It really does support my channel. Don't forget to hit subscribe and tap that bell so you get notified when we upload on Mondays and Thursdays, because this parenting gig doesn't come with a rule book. We only have each other. And I'll see you in my next video.